and to see so many familiar, friendly faces. And also, this has the very special, auspicious occasion of being our 200th concert in the Lunchtime series since we started it in August 2002. So another celebration coming up next year with the 20th anniversary. And I hope you've been faring well during the extended lockdowns. I've been doing a lot of practice and learning new repertoire, and just to prove it, I'm going to play you two big sonatas from the early 19th century, both of which I've learned in the last year or so. In fact, the Beethoven sonata I'm going to finish with, I was going to play last year as part of the Beethoven 250th anniversary commemorations. Of course, those didn't really happen in any big way. So I am going to play that for you today. But first I'm going to play a sonata by Schubert, his A minor sonata, Deutsch 784. Both these sonatas, interestingly enough, were composed in Vienna in the early 1820s. Now this Schubert sonata is rather special. Schubert had been ill the year before, and it's been suggested that the soul searching he suffered made its way into the profundity of this very big-boned work. My old professor at the Royal Academy of Music always wanted me to learn it, and I didn't oblige her. I chose another one instead. She died last year, and soon after that, I started learning this piece with this memory in mind. And I can see why she wanted me to learn it. It was a favorite of hers. Then she very kindly left me all her music. So having prepared it, I then received her copy of it with lots of markings from the many times she played it. And that was a revelation and fascinating because it just confirmed some of the things I thought she would have thought about it and gave me some new ideas as well. And I'm playing it from her copy today. So the three movements of Schubert's Sonata in A minor, Deutsch 784. Particularly listen out for the lovely singing slow movement, which has these interjecting portents of something rather dark and tragic, as though things are not quite all as they should be. There's this underlying tragedy, the sort of tragic stream running throughout the piece, and then a very bouncy and beautiful finale. Schubert's A minor sonata.
Thank you.
And back now a couple of years to Beethoven's penultimate piano sonata, his 31st piano sonata, the sonata in A flat, opus 110, composed in 1821. Now, this is quite an extraordinary work. Beethoven, in his latter years, really had broken new ground. He'd extended sonata form from the usual sort of three movements in any, with any kind of recognizable plan. He played around with it. His unique genius was touching new visionary heights. And here we have a wonderfully lyrical first movement, very spacious. Then we have a very jolly, very lively, almost sort of haunted and obsessive second movement, then a rapturous and spacious third movement, slow movement, and then no fewer than two fugues, each one a sort of inversion of the other. You hear the same theme, but you sort of heard it as if in a mirror image. It's quite an iconic work, and it was the only one of Beethoven's last three sonatas that I'd never played, and I learnt it actually a little bit before lockdown and then carrying on through lockdown with the intention of playing it last year, and of course that never happened. So it's a great delight to bring it to you to close this afternoon's programme. Beethoven's Sonata in A flat, opus 110. Today, and I hope you'll join us in July when we have the second of these two special inaugural piano recitals relaunching the series. James Lisney will be here, and there'll be some more Schubert alongside Liszt, so hope to see you then. Also, a little commercial plug, on Sunday the 13th of June, the Weymouth Music Club is marking its 75th birthday with a special concert here. The season has been suspended this year for obvious reasons. This is the sole concert of the 75th season. I'm going to be premiering a specially commissioned new piano piece by Cecilia McDowell, and I'll be joined by the violinist Antonia Kessel for works by Dvorak and Beethoven again, and also I'll be playing an intriguing little suite of pieces by a composer who was born in Weymouth in 1836. They sound very much like Schumann. If you're interested in coming to that, you will need to book in advance. The website, Weymouth Music Club, Weymouth Sunday Concerts, if you search for that, you'll find it and you'll be able to make a reservation, Sunday the 13th of June. But we hope to see you back here in July for the next Lunchtime Chamber Concert. Thank you very much for coming and a very good afternoon.